there. Z here, and yeah, that's it. Another terrible, awful, terrible, easy to make video that I'm going to be putting out here because there's a few different reasons. I've been really slow on my upload, so I'm going to try to catch that up a little bit more. I already have like my scripting for the next review that I'm going to be putting out, but it still might take a while. So I thought, hey, I might as well talk about a movie that I recently saw because very... more comments than you would probably think say, hey, Zach, you review and talk about these really shitty made movies, these schlock movies. Why don't you ever talk about recent things? And there's a pretty good reason for that. It's simply for the fact that I'm not good at it. That's pretty much it. I mean, honestly, anybody could just talk about a movie. I get that. But there are so many people who have taken classes, who are filmmakers themselves, who like movies were their entire life, so they have more experience than I do. I'm not going to lie. I've just recently started to appreciate movies in the past like 2 or 3 years because video games I got down pat. I've played plenty of video games and I still play video games, but I thought, you know, maybe I'll start watching some of the classics, some people who think they're really good movies, some people think they're really bad movies, and just kind of understand where everyone's coming from. So, today is going to be my first endeavor into it, and it's still not even going to be that great, because technically this is still just a commentary video, which, as I've mentioned before, is cancer, but I have some alcohol. I've been having some alcohol simply for the fact that you'll notice the more that I talk, kind of scruffed up voice, and I'm gonna cough a lot because I'm getting not getting over a cold. It's that weird point after a cold where you don't physically feel terrible anymore, but you have more mucus that you could fill a small kitty-sized pool, and you're coughing a lot, and your throat's fucking tore up from coughing for the past week. So, I mean, that's pretty much what I'm trying to say here. Is I'm just apologizing in advance. But a movie recently came out that I have really wanted to see, and it was The Joker. Joker movie with Joaquin Phoenix and some other people. I'm not really good at, like, mentioning writers and directors and shit like that. I'm still working up there. But Joaquin Phoenix, I know him. He was in The Gladiator. And, wasn't it? Like, that weird one where the guy wanted to fuck his phone or something? Never saw it, but I kind of want to see it now. But, I watched it. And I absolutely loved it. I really did enjoy it a lot. Now, I know a lot of people who know more about movies might be able to talk and try to find some issues with it. I didn't really see many issues. The only issues that I saw that were actually negative was it was slow. And I'm not trying to come off as like a man who's like, it wasn't as fast-paced as Marvel movies. And nobody was punching each other in the face and throwing each other from one, like, building to another, collapsing entire fucking cities, killing multiple people. No. Technically, that's still DC, but no. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, like, when you first see a movie like this, which I will classify it as artsy-fartsy, okay? I'm going to do it. I know it's not Schenectady or fucking what other artsy-fartsy movies because I can't stand them. I really don't like them, but this is the most artsy superhero film since Logan. Like, Logan is probably a very good middle-of-the-road movie where even if you have no idea who the fuck this guy is with the swords coming out of his hands, okay, things are at least ground 20, 30, maybe even 40% in reality. And that's what this one is. Actually, I feel like this one's a lot more ground in reality. But just think about Logan, but mixed with Taxi Driver. Like, has anyone ever seen Taxi Driver out there? It's like this guy who's not mentally, socially... he's like socially inept. He doesn't really know what to do. He's an insomniac. He's just trying to find stuff to do. He tries to court a woman and bring her to a porn theater for their first date. I thought that was fucking hilarious. But now thinking about it, yeah, a little bit creepy. But it's the same thing. Some guy who's not mentally there, but comes off as a living member of society. He's pulling his weight. He has a job. He's not living off the government teat. But his life sucks. And that's what this kind of is as well. It's just Joker instead of the main character of that. Again, I watched it twice and it was just like, you know, I liked it the second time more than the first because like I was trying to mention before I went off on that tangent, that when you first see these type of movies, it hits you, and you don't know, you can't really enjoy it because you're trying to look and you're trying to find things to that the movie's trying to say to you. And that's one reason why I just don't like art films, is because you're constantly, homework assignment. Like, I just want to sit here and watch a good movie with a good character. But hey, remember that one time where he picked up a used condom, and then what he did is he looped it over a door handle. That just shows that he's at the end of his rope. It's like, I didn't see that. All I saw was a crazy guy putting a condom on a fucking doorknob. Whatever, I don't know, I don't care. And I'm not going to say that this movie, that Joker, was like that to an extreme. There was definitely some metaphor, simile, alliteration. I don't fucking know what it is. There's definitely some stuff in it where you're just like, okay, I get it. I get what you were trying to do there. Yeah, okay, well, we'll move on. And, I mean, for the most, like, that's the only thing I can really think of that's a negative, is if you don't want to think that much about movies, or you feel like there's some sort of fucking story behind, or like some sort of like mental gymnastics that you have to do to understand the full depth of this story, you might not like it as much. Again, it's not like Plagued. It's not all of it. It's not Schenectady, okay? That's all I'm saying. But, there's a lot of great stuff with this movie. And I'm not going to try to get into a lot of spoilers. Not here to do that. Not here to spoil anything with you guys, because I want you to watch this movie, whether Redbox, whether going to the theater right now, renting it, buying it. Like, I just want you to see it and I want you to feel it. But there will be a little bit of spoilers, simply for the fact that I hate people who say spoiler free. It's like, oh, you're going to spoil something. You're going to spoil something. I'm not going to spoil anything major. But I will spoil some, because that's the whole point of me talking about a movie. But this man, Arthur Fleck, you know, he's just a crazy, weird guy that lives with his mom. And boy, howdy, is he awkward. The one thing I did not like about this film, but I loved it at the same time, is the cringe that's in it. And it's cringe that makes you hurt inside. Your heart hurts at some points because you're like, oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. He's going to try to do stand-up and all of his comedy is fucking garbage. Oh, no. Are we going to have to sit through this scene? Are we We're fucking sitting through the scene. Boy, howdy. Oh, I really wish I would grab a big pail of popcorn so I could pour it all out and put it on my fucking head. But there was stuff like that, but you needed to do that because you needed to feel his pain like he was feeling. Like, that, it was so good at setting up the character. It really was. Fucking sorry. Okay. So, the basic idea of the movie is he's going through his life and he keeps getting shit on until he snaps, turns into the Joker, and starts doing evil shit right back to the people who treated him like shit. The whole movie makes you feel grimy. It's the same thing. It's the same feeling I got when watching a Taxi Driver. I was like, what the fuck am I trying to say? But it's the same reason that you feel. And that I heard that's what the main guy, the director, was trying to go for. He did it fine, because it's just like, oh, this fucking city is gross. It's dirty. It's cramped. It's like, oh, jeez. And no offense to anyone who lives like that, I don't think I could. I would snap and start killing people just like him. I'd be like, fuck, there's so many people here. What fucking monkey do I have to bang just so I could get another disease going to kill off half of the people here? Fucking the Infinity Gauntlet is not real, so I'm going to have to spread this disease some way. But you know what I'm trying to say? Like, it just makes you feel gross, and it kind of gnaws at you, and it's claustrophobic, and it was annoying. But man, everything about it was exactly how you would want to portray your protagonist, even though he is a villain that is secretly wanting to kill people. And the other side is no good in this either. Nobody is a good side. You either with Arthur Fleck, a crazy man who's slowly losing his grip on reality and wants to kill everyone, or you're on the other side with the super rich who are calling all the poor people scumbag clowns. It's like, I don't, I'm just going to be a third party bystander. I'm on no one's side. Let's see some people die. I don't care on either side. I just want to see some blood. I want to see fucking a rich person going to some eyes wide shut party where some person's tied up, some poor little fucking homeless man is tied up and they're beating the shit out of him. Or I want the homeless man to go into a nice ballroom scene and just start randomly stabbing rich people. I'm here for the blood. And there was blood in this. And oh boy, it's good blood. It's satisfying. And that part of you where any video game, any TV show, mostly video games because it's more interactive, but any video game that you play, you always want to play the bad guy's side because how does it feel to be a bad guy? Well, this one you'll actually know because everybody is a bad guy. Everyone, you're just like, I don't know what side is going to kill what side, but I want to see some blood right now because this entire population needs to die off. But the whole movie was very well put together. Again, I'm leaving everything very vague, and that's all I'm sticking with. The only thing I'm going to bring up before I move on to the two-parter of this, which is just me commentating on something that's been on my mind for the past few months, but one of the perfect scenes I could think of, and this is going to be a little spoiler, it's not going to reveal a whole lot, and you've seen it in the trailer, so you probably already know what it is, but he's on this he's on the elevator and sharing it with this one woman, and this little kid's like tugging at her and talking to her over and over and over again, and she's fucking got groceries and she's just stressed out because like I'm living in this piece of shit apartment and I've been running errands all day long and now my kid's fucking tugging at my coat saying the same shit over and over again, and she's just like, she looks over at him and she's like, you know, jokingly like, hey, fucking kill me, my life sucks right now. And he just stares at her and he smiles for a bit. Doesn't say a word. They get to their floor. They both leave. They both walk their two separate ways for 5-10 feet. And then he turns around and says, hey, miss. It's like you waited way too long there, Arthur. You autistic man. You waited way too long. And that just sets up like how awkward he is and how great the writing, the acting, everything was. It was a great, great movie. And you know what I love the best about it? Because I watched that movie, I am now a psychopath incel. So let the uprising begin. Am I right, bottom text? Fuck everybody who says that. I this is where the anger is going to come in. If you just wanted to come here and see a neckbeard geek out about a movie that he's been waiting to see for 8 months, just saw it. Go ahead and click off if you don't want to hear my personal opinion about how retarded everybody is. But for any of those who do want to know, why does everything have to fucking stop around crazy people? And I'm not talking about crazy people who keep to themselves, who talk to their imaginary friends and smear shit on the walls. I'm fine with those people. Hell, I'll take pictures of them and put them on the internet because everybody loves a crazy. But the crazies that want to kill people because some imaginary message that they found in a book or some sort of media, those ones make me mad because why the fuck? Why the fuck do I have to stop liking what I like because some guy thought that it pertained to him and decided to go on a killing spree? Why? Why? Can I bring you guys' attention to exhibit number one, with Catcher in the Rye? That book has convinced so many people to try to kill other people, and it's so boring. I was forced to read it in like, I don't know if it was middle school or high school. I know I've read it, and I know I got halfway through a chapter before I went and just kind of skipped the entire chapter because I knew my teacher was only going to really ask questions about the first chapter, and then if there was like other ones afterwards, I'd just guess on those ones. But it was so boring. It was so terrible, and I don't understand why there were so many people who were just like, this makes sense. This makes sense. I didn't want to kill a musician, but now I gotta fucking kill a musician. The book says it. The book says it to me. The guy made it fucking tens of years ago, 100 maybe. I don't know when that book came out, but it only pertains to me. He must have been a fucking Ford, a future-seeing fucking Nostradamus motherfucker, because this guy knew that I needed to kill that guy over there, so I'm gonna go do it. And it happened like, if I can remember correctly, it's like 2 or 3, 4 people who want Red Catcher in their eye and thought, yeah, time to go kill. And there's nothing you could have done to stop that person. If he did not read that book, what he would have done is just been like, that dog shit. Boy, howdy. That dog shit looks a lot like a mushroom cloud. Mushroom cloud means that it's going to be dropped by a politician, because overall, politicians are the ones that control the means of destruction. The means of destruction is ultimately held by the president. I have to kill the president. That dog shit is telling me to kill the president. It's like, there's nothing you can do. There's nothing. Now, some people can argue that, hey, maybe we could just treat our crazy people better and then they won't try to kill people. We have no idea. If we treat them the best of our entire life, if we give them the best stuff ever, they're still probably going to look at a daisy and want to kill a fucking construction worker, okay? That's what crazy people are. I'm sorry. I don't know why me, a man who's moderately crazy for enjoying Futanari hentai porn, why am I the crazy person that has to get all my shit taken away when I only like some creepy stuff? That's all I like. Why do I have to get my shit taken? Why do I have to get good movies taken away? Why do I have to get babyfied fucking video games because, oh, it might tempt somebody. Oh, it might tempt somebody. Yeah, the fucking guy was going to be tempted no matter what. And this could go into a lot of different things. This could go into gun control, but that's getting too political for this channel, and I don't want to do it on this channel. All I will say is crazy people will find a reason to be crazy, and taking that stuff away from us is not really fair to us, the sane to moderately sane people, even the crazy people. Yeah, go ahead and have a schizophrenic watch this movie. Hell, he might like it if he could stop talking to the 13 other people that he's talking to and interrupting everybody else that's watching the fucking movie. But guess what? If he comes out of there and say, fucking George, I told you not to start talking to me in between there. Yeah, Jerry, you go on over there. And Lisa, why don't you shut the fuck up? I was trying to watch this movie. If he walks out of there doing that and he's not going to kill nobody besides the inner machinations of his mind, go ahead. Go ahead. Don't hurt anybody else. Preferably don't hurt yourself as well, but yourself is you. You can do whatever the hell you want. But don't take it away from us. It's every single fucking side. You had the media talking about this Joker movie that, like, they knew there was going to be mass hysteria. The incels are coming to kill everyone. They're here and they're not going to take it anymore. And then the movie just went by, and I don't think there was one thing. There wasn't one shooting, one stabbing. Some guy may have gone home and argued on the internet that it was a piece of shit movie, but that's just going to happen no matter what. And then it's the same thing. Then you have the president a month and a half ago saying video games are the root of all evil and that they cause violence. No, they don't. It's been put away for fucking years. Stop bringing it back out like it's some sort of Frankenstein, you know, argument, okay? You can't just take out parts that don't sound good and then bring in new parts and leave the really shitty parts in there, okay? Leave it alone. It's put to bed. If you're looking at it through the scientific way, there's been studies that have said, hey, this doesn't make any fucking sense. If you're looking at it through a gamer side, say, hey, I've been a gamer since I was 9 years old and I've never decided to fucking kill somebody and have sex with their corpse. And then if you're right down the middle, you could say, hey, none of this makes any fucking sense. Video games are the most popular media ever. I think. I'm trying to remember. I'm pretty sure they're the most popular media as overall. But they're the most popular media. Hey, I don't really see too many people that are just going out and killing everyone. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe in Uganda. Maybe they play that Call of Duty and they fucking go to war. They just go. Maybe in Yugoslavia, they pick up Candy Crush, and then they take candy, and then they fucking shove it down the throat of their enemies. Fuck if I know. I'm not hearing anything about it. And living where I'm living, where we have nothing to do but shoot fucking guns, drink, and do a bunch of drugs, hey, no one, not a lot of murder rate here either. So I guess I'm the crazy one here. Which would make sense, because I just told you my porn preference. So we'll find out what happens. Right here. I hate doing these videos, but you know what this feels afterwards? That tight ball in my chest that nobody else will let go on them? Family, friends are all saying, fucking don't talk to me about this, Zach. It's like a bad spirit just evacuated. I got just exercised all that badness from my chest, and it feels pretty fucking good. Pretty fucking good. So, anyways, that's all I was going to say. You guys got a review, and you guys got a rant. That's the way it's going to be. So I hope you guys have a great day, week. I'm going to start recording my review now, and I'll be working on it throughout the week. So look forward to that in another 3-4 days. weeks, months. Yeah, sure, whenever. It doesn't really matter. Cheers.